We are heading out to the new zoo this morning.
Neil Anderson joins us live from Suamico. Hi, Neil.
Hey, good morning. What a beautiful morning at the zoo, and I think we have a picture to show you guys.
Okay.
Of, you guys see it yet?
Oh, yeah, we are.
Kookaburra chick.
It's the kookaburra chick. Actually, it's a little kookaburra chick, which is the first time for the zoo to have a kookaburra hatch. And it's real important because there's only 6 institutions out there in the zoo world, out of 90-something, that have these guys that were going to produce little ones. And this is the first time for us. We have 2 little ones, and you can see they're pretty good-sized birds. And that one was about a week old last Friday, and should have feathers starting to come in at roughly around 20 days old.
So are they doing okay?
We'll hope. Oh, they're doing fantastic, and Mom and Dad are taking care of them and feeding them. We have them out on our Northern Trail building down below in an area that it's really secluded. It's worked out well, and they've been together for a couple years, and they really haven't produced any viable eggs. And this year, lo and behold, that was a fantastic thing to happen here in the last few weeks, that we were able to go ahead and hatch out these little guys, and that they're doing real well. And they'll be on exhibit then, I would say probably in about another month, once things warms up. But we're out here right now in the Eagle Aviary, and we've got all the North American waterfowl too. And we're talking about Ireland, and different animals in Ireland, all that. Yeah, Ireland, never did have snakes, but one of the birds that they used to have is they used to have golden eagles. Now, golden eagles, we find them out west and really all around the globe in the northern hemisphere, except they kind of went extinct in Ireland. And they went extinct in Ireland in about 1910, 1912, somewhere in there. So, roughly about 100 years ago. Well, a project was put together with Scotland to go ahead and bring back the golden eagle. And they were able to go ahead, they started in 1989, and it was actually in 2001 through 2007, they introduced 50 little golden eagle chicks throughout those years. Now, they had to go ahead and introduce enough of them so that once they were 4 or 5 years old, hopefully they would go ahead and breed. And in 2007, there actually was the first chick that hatched then out in the wild with a reintroduced pair. And that was almost, 100 years ago when that happened. Now, they were kind of hunted out into extinction. But it's kind of interesting because, Ireland with its, the flora and the fauna there, there's a lot of interesting things. And, they have the lowest range of breeding birds of prey of all of the European Union countries. They only have 6 birds of prey that actually breed in Ireland. But one thing that was neat with this program too is, when they hatch them out in Scotland, is them working with Scotland, that they'll take the chicks when they're 5 to 6 years old, or 5 to 6 weeks old, they bring them over, and at that time they can thermal regulate and everything, and then they get them into reintroduction pens, and then finally get them back out in the wild. So kind of neat to see that, in Ireland, that those conservation things are alive and well, and the golden eagle, now you can see them in Ireland.
We had great pictures there, close-ups of the eagle, too. It's just great to look at.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, just a study. Thanks, Neil. You have a great day. It looks like a great day for
you, too.
So I'm sure you'll be busy
today. Oh, absolutely.
It's going to be crazy.
Come on out.
Thanks, Neil.